다시 깼어!
오, 와우.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to WO Gamers League Season Number 1. I am Bizer, and joining me is the man, Jared. I'm going to unmute him.
What's up?
He's here. He's ready to go. And, well, we have Clan, Zoo, and TPM Academy taking on the first, well, stream of mine. We've had a couple from Kavaz's stream with Ix sorting it out, but that was two. Maybe we should go into the results and have a quick look at what had panned out over the last couple of days of Counter-Strike. So, just looking at it right now, ?20 Gravedigger in the first game to go out in this season, and Venom Gaming taking a 2-0 on What Is LAN. So we are in the third match for the league of the week, and a couple more to be played out, Group A and B. And I do have the bracket for you guys, or the matches, if anything.
Sorry, say again, bro.
There we go. We do have the bracket. So, good old Jared. I think he's actually playing a game right now. But
I'm zoning out. My bad.
Yeah, what? You zoned out?
Yeah. All right. I'm back. I'm ready. 100%.
I hope he is. I hope he is indeed. Okay. All right. Well, let's just get into this match. It's Clan Zoo, and we'll pull up the team. So Clan Zoo and TPM Academy. Having a look at their lineup as the official signups, in game they're going to be slightly different, but I'm sure you guys will figure out being the WA community. So Clan Zoo, Matt, Dougie, it's Doug Lower on the roster, Olitzdef, which I think he's going to go under another alias. So we'll have to figure that one out. Ads and Kavu, or Kavar, Kavu? I don't know. Don't get French on me.
I know a bit of Spanish.
Oh, enlighten me. I'd love that. Spanish is sick.
Si, senor. Dos cervezas, por favor.
Okay, all right. I know a bit of Indonesian. No, we're not going to go there. Screw it. TPM Academy's lineup a little bit awkward, nonetheless. Medler being the captain. Skeen, Redia, Twisted, and Nature. There's no sub for them. I need to mention Clan Zoo has a sub in Trance, which I think he is not playing from what I can see. Nope, Trance is not in tonight. So the full lineups are ready to go. Jared, this is where I'm sort of leaning on you, man. How do you think this is going to go tonight? Academy obviously being a second team for TPM, and we will see TPM main team after this match as well coming up. But who do you think is going to take this match, these games? We have two. I'll quickly go through the first map. So the first map selected, if I can just refresh that image, you beauty, we're going Kaish. And the second map, which we're definitely going because it's a series, will be Mirage. Two interesting maps. What do we think with both teams?
As far as I can tell, it's more slanted towards the TPM Academy as they play together regularly, but you can't really count Clan Zoo out of this because I know they have a few pretty awesome individual players as well. So, from what I've seen, Arclight, he pulls his weight quite a lot. And TPM Academy gave us a good run for our money at the most recent LAN tournament as well. So, I don't know. I don't think we versed him on Cage, though. We played Cobblestone or Train. So, in terms of aim, I'm going to give it to Clan Zoo. And quote-unquote structure, it'll go to the TPM Academy.
So TPM Academy, you reckon they're going to take both of the games?
Depends how the pistol goes, I reckon. Well, actually, how the knife, sorry. I feel like...
It's always how the knife wants to go, isn't it?
I feel like if the TPM guys start off terrorist, they'll probably have a better shot at this since they more or less know what they want to achieve every round.
Okay, all right.
But if they're CT and then they just get rolled on, they might get a bit tilted, you know?
Where is my notepad gone? I need to write this down. Oh, jeez. Wise has left his notepad in the kitchen. Oh, well, I'll scribble on some paper. So the predictions, you're saying, if I'm correct, 2-0 to the TPM Academy.
I'm not saying that. I definitely feel like I don't know, it's kind of a coin flip, to be honest, because like I said, one team's got a lot of very, very good AIM players. The other team's, I'm not going to say they're not as good with the AIM, but they'll have more structure. But that isn't always what you need. I mean, holding W and tapping every now and then works out a lot better than some people think.
So you're thinking that being Cache is the new Dust 2, practically, that this could go either way?
Yeah, I kind of feel like it's going
to
be...
probably more favoured to them being... their sort of map. Look, I'll be 100% honest with you guys. Yeah. I'm not 100% on all the teams, as I haven't seen much of the play over the last 6 months. But this is where I'm sort of heavily relying on you, my son Jared, and everyone out in chat. It seems we've got Belly, Steve, Kavaz out there as well. So you guys, give us your predictions and we'll see how it all runs. But I'm going to go down your line. You're saying 2-0, but you're not wanting to confirm it. You're a bit Aminari. You want to give us predictions for the maps?
Well, I'm one of those guys that likes to change my mind as shit's unfolding, so... let's say AIM, Clanzu's got it 100%. Strats could go either way, but as I would say, it's more of a 60-40 because TPM Academy are obviously playing together non-stop. Sorry, shouldn't say non-stop, regularly.
Okay, all right, well, it's... I thought we were about to get into the knife round. It's all getting underway in a second. Hopefully they're ready to go knifing. Look, I'm going to lean one map each way, just for the hell of it, just for a bit of fun. I think Clanzu will take Cache, and then we'll see Mirage go to TPM Academy, but it'll be some close matches. We might go out the distance as well. As the guys, they're going to get into knifing, so this is going to be super interesting. Are you in with us? Ready to go?
Yep.
Awesome. Well, I always love to chuck the knives around to yourself, so off you go, man.
Alright. So, who we got? Oh, shit. That happened way too... Alright, so let's see if we can pull it off. Is he on 100? No.
Oh, there you go. TPM Academy, they pick up the knife. You're a little bit concerned about Clanzu and how they were going to execute. They're looking like they're going to stay, no?
I hope they switch, to be honest.
Switch teams. They have gone to switch teams. So,
see, I feel like that's probably not the right decision. In my opinion, if you're versing a team that has better aim than you, you'd rather have them on the counter terror so you can just do dumb shit to get a few rounds on the board. Whereas the reverse being the team with the better aim always being the aggressor, I feel like it's kind of slandered to their favor. So I reckon this is looking like a 9-6 half to Clanzu.
All right, well, they're splitting out, and a couple of decoy nades are out at B at the moment, slowly creeping up.
Three walking squeaky, one watching the mid lurk, and one coming up A main. Simple and effective.
It looks like an execute, and Raider's going to be the first one. Oh, that is big for the first look for him. He picks it up, but he's going to have more encounter now. The information's out, so we'll go
refrag
down.
For
The trade is on right now. Lowland's death in default. He's sparring for his smoke, almost grabbing a headshot with that one. Troy up with a shot. See, he's fully on his bomb site right now, and it's left up to Acrolyte and his teammate, which was on the bomb down, and now they're going to push him. He's got one. This will be a big, big play if he can pick up two. He's going to charge and not going to happen. CT's with the first round.
That wasn't going to go in his favor, to be honest, seeing where the bomb was planted. At least the terrorist got the money, though.
Alright, I'm just going to fix something up. You can keep talking, my friend.
Alright. So I'm expecting a full eco from the terrace, unless I get a cheeky P250 or something. One bullet. What's this looking like? Yeah, a few SMGs coming out, one scout, four UMPs, a lot of nades for the CT side, and P250s and flashes for terrace. Very, very slow B coming out here. Flash the bust. 5v1, this isn't gonna look good for him. Ooh, one for nature. One for twisted and the refrag from Arclight. 3v3 now. Still guns on the CTs. No armor on the Ts. So we got one under heaven. One backside. Oh, 2v2.
Oh. Skane. With a 2 clean up.
Skinny picks it up.
Raider's already on.
Raider gets the defuse.
Well, good start by TPM Academy, and maybe my prediction's pretty much going out the door. Did anyone give us a prediction out there? I'm just scrolling through. Shout out to Stevie. My man, Steve. Have to give him a... give him Mr. Mod. There you go, Stevie. You can look after my chat as we get into the third round. T's back out, and well, 2 bomb plants for them, and also getting a bit of damage on to the TPM Academy has given them the opportunity to set up here.
So we got 2 players going slow up on the boost.
But you should have a look where Slick Rick is.
Oh, yeah. I feel like he's going to get checked. Oh, sorry. As soon as that nade flies over, hopefully he's smart enough to look straight up. Don't let me down, Ricky. Oh, picks up one.
Well, they haven't checked.
Oh, gets the second.
Thank you very much. That's going to be losing the mid control as the rest of the clans head out through the connector. But his radar
last
stopping and turns around the corner. Acolyte waiting for him. Now 1v2 to coming up far away.
Acolyte's got a 1v1 before the rotate comes in, so he's...
It'll be a 2v1 now. He's up in the corner. Turns
oh, 1v1.
Gets the one. There's a spray coming out. Great trade to come. And as predicted, TPM Academy taking the third round. But a little bit of damage done to them. If we... well, I can't actually do my mouse. Oh, well.
So in terms of money, not a lot going on for the T's right now after that buy.
Nah, well, look, they're forced up early, so... A strategy by them. They're going to be interesting to see how they go about it. Twist is going to encounter a little bit of a bit of noise from that garage section. This time they hold off. A bit delayed here, Clanzu, but they're going to exit out. They're going to head out now. Slick Rick coming through and again lighting up the scoreboard for his team. Nature with another one.
He's getting quite cashed up too off all these SMG kills.
It's default now. Picks up a gun and. Well, this will be a hard fought save if he's going to go for this. The bomb sitting back in the middle.
He's going to get smashed right now.
What do you reckon? Do you reckon this is the right
in the head?
Or should he just
bang. See, to be honest, at that point in time, saving the M4 wouldn't have been worth it. So, he would have had to go for a kill. Probably didn't have to go directly to middle. Could have snaked his way around through CT, out to Z or something. But what's done is done.
Well, 1 round away from max bonus for Clan Zoo. Up in A case this time with that save, full utility as well. It'll be interesting to see what play they put out into motion. They are working really quickly to gain the map advantage.
They're very
interesting hold
very
by TPM Academy, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. So they got the one player in the vent for the B support and the cheeky pick towards boost or mid main. Which frees up the guy at Z to, you know, not have to take any duels until he's asked to. I feel like the first frag of the round is going to go... I feel like it'll go in Clan Zoo's favor.
It's pretty far spread, so they really are looking for a frag pretty quickly.
As you'll notice, people aren't really pushing up too far on the CT team. They're quite confident in just holding back, so... That could get Clan Zoo a little faster. There we go. Dougie with the first kill. So he's out under vent now. And as both vents are popped, they can drop down into B with minimal resistance. Or making minimal noise, sorry. Ricky gets another cheeky kill with the UMP. Goes for a second. Gets traded. Nature gets 1, 2... And now, Bomber's on the B site with his closest teammate running B main, knife out.
It's funny enough, Skane's gone all the way out. Sort of catching the back end of this. They've got a chance to grab this, being TPM...
Troy could get timing right here, but I doubt it. Nope. So both players are lit. Raider could pull this off. Oh, didn't see him.
They're not inside. They're going to be a peek in the corner. And Troy will take him out with a shot on. Very accurate right now. And that's the first there for Clan Zoo. Don't need the bonus.
They're on the board, boys.
They're on the board. What do you reckon, Jared? Just is the start of something for Clan Zoo. Comes right back to TPM Academy. Completely.
It depends on how this round goes, to be honest. They're eating through their money with those rebuys because a lot of them are dying. Whereas,
it's interesting where they're working. It's a complete spread out to mid. Not far. Well, they actually did find a kill, so they backed right off and now looking for a default standard split, but more leaning to the A bomb site. And I just wonder if Clan Zoo are going to invest a player to head over to B, because it seems to be not the read. TPM Academy could be doing some damage here. Clan Zoo execute out onto the bomb site. Smoke set.
So as it stands, there's two players towards A. Well, I think default's trying to sell the fake, but they're not going to fall for it. Well, especially now since the bomber got a frag. Oh, Slick Nick. Oh, Slick Rick's not going to have time. He needed to get a lot closer. Unless he picks him up now. Oh, not today, son. So Ruthless gets a frag on Slick Rick. Closest rotators and Z watching a line on CT.
Yeah, there's no gun to grab either as well. So, yeah. It's do or die. I think Skeen just needs to see if he can take some cash off Clan Zoo. This is not really a good scenario for him. He's got a CZ for his troubles. I'm hoping it would have been a better gun than that, but
if Arclight gets curious, he can pick up this cheeky frag on him. Get the AK. Oh, the angle. Nice. Oh. He's going to go for it. He's got to go now. He's got to get out. Oh, gets a second.
That was
traded before the third.
That was,
so overall, they got 3 AKs off the T's plus armor, so that's 11.1k minimum, and they only spent between the five of them 7.5, so that's a win for them even though they lost.
Yep.
I can't be bothered doing the math to figure out how much money they got off the bomb though, so let's just leave it at that.
Yeah, look, interesting TPM Academy, the rounds they have won, as you're saying before, most of the time they've had to rebuy, so they're dropping a lot of players. So Clan Zoo, even though they've lost the first couple of rounds, they do have the ability to get back into this game and force Academy, what would be the second eco, to just to try and get that cash flow from them. And even so, if they do the same again, where they reset them again, we're looking at 3 resets within the first 10 rounds, which is a scary thing for TPM Academy, but they've got the lead. So just need to be a little bit more clever with how much money they're going to spend on it, but also make sure they're trading properly and not letting Clan Zoo through when they do win the rounds.
Yeah, definitely. Well, Skinny's kind of screwed here. They got 3 players out middle into vent straight away, doing a split on B. And Nature's about to get bodied too. Oh, actually, he hasn't been seen yet.
Oh.
Picks up 2. Nature.
He hasn't got a gun. He didn't want to risk for the gun.
Oh! Look at how quickly that's turned around. Now it's default in a 1v4, 1v3.
Only 1 AK, Slick Rick with it. Skine and Raid are not able to pick up the guns as yet as they're down in the bomb site. Default just wondering, listening. 25 seconds remaining. He needs to get to work. A lot of money invested here by Clan Zoo into this round, and wouldn't look nice if they go down. Now it's across. He sees ahead, doesn't get the pop. Flash coming out of the top of heaven, and they both jump onto him, and that will be a big round for TPM Academy. Went on a double eco, and they came away with 3 AKs there and cleaning out Clan Zoo.
That was a really smart play by them, watching the ramp, because he knew he couldn't get to the bomb site, and then with the third player watching the CT line, but not exposed, he essentially had to kill 3 people in, 3 seconds to actually have a chance at that.
Eco now for Clan Zoo. They're going to head straight to A main. Looks like this is going to be quick and maybe a clean up here for Radar. If he plays the line right, they're going to head around.
One's out fork, 2 out fork, 3 out. Raider's about to get traded. He's on 1 hit. Even a block will take him down.
Not bad round.
2v2 here. 40 health apiece. Oh, scratch that. Last player, quad, 33. About to get smashed. And Nature takes him down easy. Must have taken significant damage from his teammate, though, because Troy got the assist.
Look, not a bad round coming out on that one. I think Japan. So yes, they went down and weren't able to get the bomb out of that, but they have pulled back TPM again with cash and just over time. But right now, you gotta watch this.
They're doing alright for money, actually.
They are, but Doogie, he's on Deagle. Doesn't have an AK in hand.
Alright, first pick for Arclight, taking out Twisted. Let's see what's the next on the cards. So we still got a slow A coming out here as they're pouring on the site. Two behind red though. Oh, and Raider gets that frag on death. Troy walks into his crosshair as well.
Literally playing the smart.
Still a 3v3. Smart play here by Skinny. Easy frag on the forklift. Yeah, there we go. Easy frag on the forklift, guys. We got one guy main, one guy posted up quad. It's a process of elimination, guys. You know they're going to be quad and main. He's not squeaky.
Oh, he's going to get two frags flying
up.
Oh,
no.
Acrolyte saying thank you very much. Doogie will get the last one. What the hell happened? Like you said, it was a process of elimination. They checked the spots, and then that should have been the next point. He steps out to line up, and he takes that one. Clan Zoo, I think, almost pretty lucky to get away with that one.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I feel like these TPM guys, in that round at least, they looked a bit unsure as of what to do. I wasn't looking at what nades they had, but a cheeky smoke and sit could have paid off. Assuming they had one, of course.
Well, I got like with the first frag, as Twister got a little bit aggressive in the midsection there.
Got a decent attack on him though, 87.
Tried to have a peek.
At least puts him on the back foot.
Drop out in the moment. Clan Zoo just spreading thin. But what do you think, Jared? TPM Academy doing quite well at the moment with the rounds?
Yeah, they are. As I was saying, they need to get a little bit more curious to a certain extent. You know, see what's happening so they know. See what's not going on so they know what is going on.
That is a quick early call coming out as the flash was into B. And straight out, TPM have just realized they've been absolutely
just got
baited into rotating on site. And now this will be a T side heading out there and looking for the clan out already. Oh, wow.
1v5. Good luck, mate.
We have a Deagle, which only has 7 bullets.
Oh. Tagged him twice for 90 on. Bad luck, Major.
Out you go.
Alright, it's a 6-4 as it stands.
Alright, big shout out to Ix out there. You're getting absolutely nailed by Nightbot. I've given you mod access, mate, so do what you want. Keep it good. I know Stevie loves a bit of live action, so big shout out to Stevie. And mate, you're more than welcome to join me on stream if you feel like it, son. Remember the old Giro back again. We've had fun. We played back in the day. Steve always what, mate? I was never that great, and I was just stuck to my guns in commentary.
Yeah, he's an excellent player.
Slow round, Clan Zoo. Just taking it back a little bit, but as you know, buy up rounds usually take the time and effort, especially on cash. No fast executes. A lot of utility spread so far. Ruthless is really interesting how he's working the AWP as a first man line into this B bomb site. He's going to check all the lines, but I'm just waiting.
This guy's got brass balls. Oh, Arclight gets the first kill on Nature. And is that Twisted? Yeah, Twisted holding the line. Oh, about to get smashed by Ruthless. That collateral rip
should have been a shot. Saw the body, saw it like maybe a tag, and then he stepped out, exposing himself with AWP. Wrong move, if anything. Very, very lucky Twisted. He could have gone.
Bomber gets traded. So now Skinny knows the bomb's on A site with at least one, and they are not aware that the highway guy is lurking, and there's now another guy A main. So really, all that Arclight has to do is just bide his time. I mean, Twisted's about to walk into his crosshair. There he goes. So the double truck wall push. But they're exposed from every angle. And Arclight picks up the three-piece feed. Easy money.
Was it the three-piece or the four-piece, man? I believe it's a four-piece.
Actually, yeah, it was a four-piece feed, plus potato and gravy. Got the free upsize to large.
Oh, damn. Big shout out to KFC, eh?
Yeah. We should get sponsored by KFC.
That would be epic. It's a good old four-piece feed. Oh, well, very good. At the moment, CT's looking to just light up the T-hole right now and maybe able to get a frag. Doogie stepping out with two. Still in A main. I think this is where Academy should just disappear and head back to hold just a little bit passive on site. I'm really wanting to step out here. He's going to spray, which gives all information out to Nature. And he might even
Noise for the sake of making noise. I feel like TPM, if they fully committed that push, would have ended up better off. I mean, two of the guys have got down to, 10 odd health. It's just one shot each. And this round wasn't really about, 100% win. It's about stopping the bomb plant more than anything.
It's funny that it's taken so long to get the bomb light. All the information was there for Clan Zoo to say, hey, it's all commitment of A, let's go to B. Still, TPM haven't even sent a person over to B, so it's all about sticking together with this strategy and the pistol and seeing if they can knock a couple of frags down. At the moment, five-man piece of Clan Zoo waiting for the two-man piece.
Yeah, see, them dying this late in the round isn't going to be worth it for anybody. I mean, one, they haven't gotten any kills out of it, and two, they didn't... Oh, sorry, take that back. They got one kill. They might be able to save that gun, but having no armor and nothing really to save from this... I mean, keeping one AK for the sake of the other team losing one player and getting a bomb explosion isn't really worth it.
Yeah, I'd think they're going to hunt.
I think he'll stay alive. Yeah, he'll be fine. I don't think you can spray through that. Cheeky.
I love it when it gets to that point and I'll be like, wow.
I think he might have clenched really hard just then.
Yeah.
Alright, okay. So now Clan Zoo's money is actually looking shit tons better than it was a few rounds ago. Picking up all of these kills in the bomb plants as well. Everybody's above 4.5k, so they can rebuy AKs about, I think, for the next two rounds, assuming they get no nades. No early fights going on, just a few taps through the smoke. I feel like TPM's lost all their presence at middle. I mean, the first few rounds they were winning because Slick Rick was pushing up real close.
Yeah, they haven't had that orb, but...
Now they're expecting it, and he's going to burn. No, no. You know, he's had enough of that, so he stepped into the corner. Smart move, Ricky. He's got two people holding lines on him, though, so...
It's not funny enough, Clan Zoo. I didn't see it, but Clan Zoo has been interesting as Skyne gets called out right in front of Squeaky Door. Troy will take that frag and maybe equal it up, and Raider able to trade.
I feel like Clan Zoo just sort of coming in their own little.
They don't really have a strategy to hit these bomb sites. If anything, like A bomb site, we haven't really seen some great executes, and B. It sort of has been a slow migration over there. In any rounds they decide that he's a little bit too hard. As Acrylite works in and gets a shot on Nature, not able to capitalize on the site. That would be a bomb plant down. But Clan Zoo, funny enough, the six rounds they've got, it hasn't been convincing in my eyes.
See, at this point in time, well, actually, since the start, it's been a lot of Arclight and Dougie just getting cheeky... Sorry, entry frags on whichever site they're going to. Sorry, I just burped.
Did you really do that?
Huh?
You totally did that.
Did what?
Don't worry.
Anyway, yeah.
I'm sorry, but that's a first for me.
What, burping?
Yeah, well, on a stream. On a cast, mate. On a shoutcast. Come on.
I had a really fizzy beverage and...
What, Mountain Dew?
It's kind of out of my control. Nah, actually, it's Mother.
Ugh.
Wait a minute.
I thought we were continuing the KFC talk, man.
Oh, nah. You don't go for Mountain Dew when you go to KFC. You get a Pepsi Max, right? Because you've got to limit your sugar intake. And if you're going to make yourself feel like a piece of shit after you eat all that chicken, you need to, you know, you need to kind of feel good about it. Coke Zero, Pepsi Max, Cheeky 7-Up.
Well, Mick and Troll completely given away here. CT's back on an eco. And we talked about how many ecos they had to go through. Twisted making the advantage. Going forward to play there, and this is now the information for Clan Zoo, but they're going back instead of moving forward because that bomb was dropped. So CT's have a position here. Slick Rick's going to get caught out. Doogie takes him, and now the Academy have headed back. But 2Ks now, and I reckon they'll be able to work a strategy around at least to hold a bomb site properly. And I think Nature, all he needs to do is be aggressive. They're not going to pick him up. Yes, they do. Nice shot coming from Ruthless onto that, and now leaving. Well, a 3v3, Twisted low HP, two guns, possibly a chance for Academy. Wouldn't it be around an eco round, you know, aimed around one AK, and just to bring it back, 45 seconds to see what they're going to do.
Yeah, this is interesting. Dropping out of mid with the AWP, going in first, really. Get seen. I don't think they've spotted the bomb yet, though, have they?
No, nothing's been called. No one's moving at the moment. But this is a
so Arclight's still got... He knows that there's got to be one quad because he's lit. And he'll be smart enough to check it easy. Just going to shoot him in the back of the head. Oh, there we go.
They're all lit. And, well, that should be the round. I'm not sure what Skeen's doing here. He should just back out. Straight away, he's too aggressive. They're going to come looking and... Well... He's got away with that one. That was just a millimeter of a shot. He will get the headshot.
If he pre-fires fork, he might get a cheeky two-piece.
I think he just needs to back out here.
Depends how hungry he is.
Save that AK. You got the exit frag, which is good. Try and limit the money, but I don't think it's going to really matter. One more round in the half, and most of the T-side are pretty lit with cash. So just a little bit more for him. I'll be questioning if Nature could be buying up properly, but Raider with 6K should be able to drop.
So yeah, I think Skinny's going to have to drop him.
Academy should be able to go full guns. Probably not full utility. Clan Zoo, on the other hand, I reckon they could go double off if they really wanted to.
Yeah, well, like I called in ninth round, 9-6 is what I was seeing this being, and looks like it may come into fruition. If Arclight just keeps doing what he's doing, he's just going to tear these guys apart. CT won't be exactly be the same because he won't have the freedom to move around and just shoot at people unless that's how he feels like playing it.
Slick Rick to the AWP into the bomb site. Tasked with handling the site by himself. Again, split from Academy.
Playing a very aggressive line, too. Oh, gets the pick, though. Pays off. See, now this could go 7-8. If anyone else died, I wouldn't say the same, but because Arclight's out of the way, they got a shot. Landing up a few cheeky A smokes, it seems. Molly in the quad. So now they know they're just going to look behind Red and Forklift. That's Fork. That's Red. Highway players. And one going to E-Box for the P-Box. Oh, Nature's lagging something chronic. 700 ping. Ouch.
Ouch, man. That's not what you want to be.
Yep. 9-6.
A good round.
Here we go, boys.
It is.
I mean, some people say
it's
I'm
up
psychic.
To Twisted here to
I believe in him.
Nature will probably come around the corner and get a cheeky spray down of the ping regardless. But here comes Twisted. Now, the 1v1.
All Nature needs to do
is
make noise.
The ping is coming back down for Nature. They're going to crouch on him and they will take it. Defuse straight up there. Plenty of time for Twisted. And like we said, it could have been Clan Zoo. Thank God that ping came down. But TPM Academy. Cheeky to get seven rounds. How many ecos did they had to go through there? It was funny enough, they had really good eco rounds in Clan Zoo. Well, that was a little bit worrying for them. On their bye, knowing the other team's eco, they gave up guns, also rounds. It could have been a 10-5 half in favour to them, but probably struggling on that respect. Now they've got to hold CTs. The question is, what can the Academy do on a T side?
Yeah. I'm thinking... I'm thinking Academy's got the advantage on this half, definitely.
We're lining up for Bear.
It's always T-sided.
Pop flash coming across, delayed.
So they got a 3v3 at B right now.
It's going to be interesting. Rufus caught out in the mid. Firefight goes and he'll get dropped. There is another CT down and now they put the Molly into the bomb site. Two are going to encounter the full force of the Terracite as they enter in. It's a crossover and one back of site. Acrolyte picking one. Site goes down. And now CT's on the rotation. PM going to be able to get this bomb down. Good round to start.
It's all up to Dougie. 1v4. Pushing B main with the USP. See if he can add 4 more kills to that. That's one. Tap, lad, tap. Kill them all.
It's given away the position, but then again, they already know where he was. Now coming out with counter flash. Through the lineup sight. This would be scary if they both line up. He's caught out in a position. Crossover will get him, and that will be the round. TPM Academy were looking for it. And again, starting with the pistols rounds. They had the first 3 pistol rounds on CT side, and now they're going to be upgrading on the T side. Can they hold out the second and third?
I hope so. If Clan Zoo plays their force by rounds anywhere near as good as TPM did the first half, it's definitely going to be a very close game because they were getting a lot of money out of the game in those rounds, whether they were winning them or not. So
that nade coming from Doogie, that would have been interesting if it lit up the guys looking to boost, but completely missed all of them.
Scout mid, no armor.
Risky,
very,
isn't it?
Yeah, very risky.
Ambitious, I dare say.
Yeah. Silly, that word comes to mind a bit.
Maybe. I try to be constructive.
But actually, you don't need armor if you don't plan on getting shot, so that's clearly his MO. He doesn't want to get shot, so he doesn't need armor.
Alright, well, Academy now looking to get a little bit aggressive on site. A little bit of noise is going to be made here by Skyne just to keep the rotation, but the call is B. They're still taking their time here. Clans are maybe thinking, oh, it's delayed and they're going to rush through at A. And so, of course, the rotation leaving one on site. Acrolyte with the line. Now looking for mid control. They're going to help themselves through the entrance of B. Acrolyte not connecting. Ooh. Finally gets one. Doogie lining up the mid section right now. Twisted. This is going to force Scout down.
Ow.
And Clan Zoo will clean it up with Crossfire as an Academy. Well,
they just got bodied. No trades at all. 5 kills. All their guns gone. That was a very, very huge round for Clan Zoo.
You're not wrong. And funny enough, it's like that's what Clan Zoo needed to do to Academy as well. But hold on there. On the eco rounds, that were challenged out. But now they'll be able to buy early in a full eco coming out from Academy. And the question is like, how do they move quickly or do they try and work these frags back into their occasions? Because when they've been patient on the eco, it really has
paid off
for them. But
yeah,
but it is a different side right now. They're hunting. And Clan Zoo, they're just going to wait for the heads to pop around the corner with the Colts in hand. And
Five people flooded out on A.
They're all flashed out. Troy's going to have a field day, but he can't connect with them. They're all around quad right now.
Oh, they still get the plant though.
Bomb will go down, and that's what the Academy were looking for. Last player cleaned up, and Troy, my son. An
Troy chose
to have a 5-piece.
He chose a
1-piece.
He chose a very questionable line, to be honest. I mean, he couldn't see anything happening anywhere.
I'm surely he heard all of them push through. You could hear
yeah,
it all
so
go.
Why didn't he react?
Because the funny thing is they'll all be checking lines in that top box as well. The fifth player, he's waiting for the fifth player to come around. Then he can get stuff up there. And the pop flash that came out by his teammate, clever, but he just couldn't line up heads. If that was a scenario for him to ace, courtesy of his teammate flash. Unfortunate.
Yeah.
They'll get the round. But interesting bomb plant coming down from TPM. Now they're fully brought up. It is time for gun rounds. And this is a close encounter. Let's see if Clan Zoo can continue to hold their lead.
So there's only 2 mollies for Clan Zoo right now, which means they've got to use their gun to clear space. Sorry, for TPM, my bad. Ooh, nice pick for Skinny, taking down Ruthless at mid. Easy one tap. And as it stands, we have Arclight hiding in the snacks position with the T's backing off back towards A. All 3. And Troy just chilling back at quad.
It's not a bad call at all. And do they have, yes, they got a molly, so Nature should actually flame this out here.
There it goes. Oh, he missed.
The wrong side. Troy's going to have a go.
Troy with a spray down.
They're able to trade, but now Default there.
Default's got this easy.
He's got the angle. They're not going to step out. He does. Oh, what a flick from Skyne.
He just got body.
Poor Acrolyte. He's been sharp so far on the B bomb site. Now got two to contend with. Angle's crossfire, which is going to hurt. Need to check the
shot in the back of the head.
He's spraying out. It's not going to get it. Nature finishing it off. And good round coming out from Academy. Bringing us back to a close game. It's 9-10 at the moment. Clan Zoo with advantage. But it seems to go back and forth at the moment. No one really gathering any momentum in this early rounds of the second half.
That flick that Skinny just got was huge. Smashed old mate straight at forklift, so that definitely won them the round there, because that 2v2 was not looking pretty for him.
Oh. Nature able to give the communication back. Those AWP on B, very risky to come out. Default to have the AWP, but maybe that's what you need, a risk for reward. Being so close, need a standout play from him. Soloing B at the moment. Actually, Acrolyte's got a boost. Not a boost, he's worked through the mid. So, VidCon given up by Academy and Clansu. We've got quite a bit of map control right now.
Still seems like these guys are very reluctant to push for information, though. TPM is still trying to make their minds up as to what they're doing at any given point in the round. So all it takes is one guy to run for, I don't know, 3 or 4 seconds forward, see nothing, and come to his team. But as it stands, they're not really getting any information until they're getting shot in the face.
Playing the smoke right now inside Acrolyte. Going to listen for the bomb. One player hasn't been seen. But they're all going to go to Lions. Default, that AWP. There's a boost coming. A main's connected. Now, he should be backing off Default. He has spent a lot of money on the AWP early.
Smart man.
Need to disappear. And funny enough, they're not going to charge him. Academy quite happy to let the AWP go.
Well, they would want to get it out of the economy, but at the same time, you don't want to just run into a silly line and just get smashed for it, you know? Actually, Twisted could... No, he's not going back for it.
Cash is an issue for both sides. I don't think Academy want to risk any more AKs. The economy is really a key thing when the game's getting close, so... Bit of a save. Would have been nice if you could take the AWP, but Default almost working for him, but it was a questionable buy. He's now his team will have to force a strategy around him to keep the AWP, I'm hoping.
I feel like it'd be good if he went for the B pick. But he's sent his little minions over there.
All to be and...
taken down by nature too. Dougie gets one trade. Oh, and he snuck past. Dougie knows he's there.
Oh, Dougie has ate that nade. Not very nice on his behalf.
It's not looking fun for them right now.
Canary taking their time, however. They know the bomb site's sort of theirs. Just need to work it.
Finally, Rado. Troy's creeping up A-Main. 2v3 with an AWP on Default. This has potential. Troy's just gotta nut up and run for it, though. He's needs to back his mate up.
Well, they're flashing to hell and...
Walking through the van ain't doing himself any favors. And let's see if Slickrit gets this one. Here it comes. Bang. There he goes. And then Default's gonna run away and save two in a row.
Well, two saves in a row, and I think this time Academy should hunt. I think now you got a little bit of bank. There is a little bit there. Not everyone's sort of forcing right now, but I think go take this AWP out. It'll be really crucial now. Clan Zoo, perhaps, money-wise, a little bit risky for them. For CT come next round, so Default. It might be a force buy to suit this as the T's now taking the lead. Clan Zoo... Right now, I'll be taking a pause and a timeout to figure out what you want to do.
I feel like at this point in time, yeah, that would do them quite well. Assuming they can iron out the wrinkles. But They have to force this one if they're going to rebuy on 14. So it'll be a force here, then an eco, and then a full buy, well, assuming.
Not much money at all. Default, we'll go back to B on his line. Full set of AKs. Utility as well.
They're really jumping the gun with the grenades as well.
Troy getting the first frag for his team.
At least they're keeping the Molotovs.
Banzoo looking to be good, but heaps of time in this round. Work to be done by Twisted. Interesting hold by Clanzoo. Spread all over the map, just trusting in their aim. And again, Academy, I think just looking for a little bit of information, but they're going to look to control this mid and Ruthless. He could definitely have a good time here on the box. It gets taken, traded out by Slick Rick.
Now the bomb has been seen. It's under vent. Invent. Oh, it gets taken down.
Oh, it's dropped.
So it's up to Twisted to pick up the pieces.
I like Doogie here, Douglas. He's gone around highway now, put himself back out to Z, and they won't be checking that line, thinking he'll still be up highway. And if he steps out, he can get himself a frag. Yes, he gets one. Doesn't peek for the
second. Smart not to go for the second.
And a bomb there it is. Now was up highway, and a stronghold coming from Troy as well. Doogie and Troy teaming up well for Pansu. The buy-up working out for them, and now some money in their bank to strengthen it up right now. And Academy forced on. Yep, they're going to force out here. A couple of the players can. So three AKs, and we're looking at Adigo and a Tech 9 for Nature and Raider.
Both teams are actually pretty broke as it stands. Assuming... Oh, look, this goes pear-shaped.
Yeah, Clan Zoo's naturally going to be a lot less, being CT side. A lot more they need to invest into their rounds, but that last round able to give them the ability to get the utility up and bank. But if they lose this one, yes, there'll be a full reset coming up for them. Double boost that box, Twisted opting to stay out of that one. This will be interesting, Ruthless. Looking right at the line. Just listening for a jump. There's going to be a flashover now. Ruthless knows there's one on the garage roof. It's going to come down. But the aim's going to be a question. And it gets taken by Slick Rick.
Controlled. I feel like 80% of Rick's kills have been in that exact corner at middle.
The ninja spot. I love it, Troy. Oh, with a flick. Takes out Squeaky as well. And they hold on to the bomb site. The Academy looking to execute. And now... Paul Slick Rick and a whole world of hell. He's going to turn the corners. He's not spotting. That is default AWP with him. He's got a line as well. Slick's going to throw out the pistol to bait. Oh, it's worked. He knew he was there. He'll take the AWP and maybe try and clutch with it. I don't think it's the right weapon to go, but why not?
If he had an extra 20 seconds on the clock, I'd have faith in him. But as it stands, probably just got to save it. Maybe pick up Doggy. Oh, no.
Oh,
take off like good enough.
Doggy, now in the corner. He's going to stay hidden. Tech 9 in hand for the rush. He's going to go here. He's going to push him. Oh, it's going to be a battle on the ops drop. Slick Rick doesn't get away with it. And Academy back on, well, stations for them. Doesn't look good. Their money completely down in Clan Zoo. They're going to have to force a little bit of rebuy here. Still means the economy a little bit strict. So just swapping some guns around. You can tell a UMP for Ruthless. Hard story for them. But at the moment, Academy, this could go completely against them. And the buff will start to open up for Clan Zoo.
First pick for default. Taking down Twisted with the AWP. And looks like a B push coming out here. Oh, and they're just getting mowed down. So that's two for default. Sorry, three for default, and then two for Slick Rick, was it? Sorry, no. Wrong team. Ruthless, my bad.
I didn't think that was too bad for Ruthless, being the UMP as well. That gun does have the ability to spray quite well and mow the team down. There's a pause coming out here, so the tactical right now, having a think about what they want to do and how they want to go. What do you do? Your Academy right now, cash, questionable. Do they save and then perhaps buy?
They know, buy Tech Nines. Buy for, right?
Yeah, Tech Nines now. See if they can push a site, take the orps and the guns out of Clan Zoo. Get themselves.
Tech Nine and one smoke, right? If they ping a smoke at B main off the window sill so it lands at the entrance to the site and they just man pile through that smoke. At least one of the two guys that's defending is going to be looking at the edge of checkers.
Okay.
So at that point, right, it's a coin flip.
The call right here is a utility buy with a couple AKs, three AKs, and two Tech 9s. I'm a little concerned. We'll see what strategy it is. Maybe a B deployment. We know Default's going to be there. We know Roofless is going to be there at B for a stack on. This will probably be at the point where... Clan Zoo will probably be thinking twice. Okay, what do we do here? Do we stack a particular bomb site? Do we trust in a hold that's got us this far? You know, it's been going back and forth at the moment. Three rounds to Clan Zoo, but there was three that went to TPM as well. You know, all close rounds thus far. Not really anyone's having a full survival apart from that last round. That was pretty much a clean out where Clan Zoo now have a bit of momentum. So, I don't know. What do you do, TPM? Now you've got three AKs, two... Tech Nines, where do you send them? Do you go and
click? I think either a fast A or B or just a fast mid, because the more time, I'm not going to say wasted, but if they keep the pace up, it gives them less shit to worry about and it gives the other team a lot of shit to worry about. You know, if they just say run forward and click, it's like, all right, I know where I need to look, I know what I need to do. And the other team's is under as much pressure as they are. So yeah, my I'd say a fast B with three through main and then two out mid or something like that, you know? Just keep it simple. I mean, people play the same spots every time. They bust out, what are they gonna clear? Checkers, heaven, headshot, sight, and CT. And if they smoke a bunch of those things, then even easier.
Let's just stick Rick, smoke, following out the entry. CTs are super aggressive on mid control. Not a bad deploy for them. Be interesting to see how T's now to go. Now it's going to be a boost over. A boost over. Dougie's got, well, he stayed up. He got a frag from that. So good start. That's actually taking one of the AKs out as well. So hopefully one of the T sites can wrap back around and grab that at least to make sure there's three AKs going at all times. But I'm a little concerned for Academy right now. This game could be slipping away from them.
Yeah, that's true. Just depends on how. Not so much greedy, but how adventurous Clan Zoo are feeling, because while they know that they're on the back foot, they could pick up a few cheeky kills when they're not expecting it. I mean, we've got two in A main, one posted up at Squeaky, making no noise until now. The miss. That's one. Three out through the smoke.
Great flash.
Oh, they're just getting picked apart.
There'll be two more. He's going to step around. 4K coming for Troy. Thank you very much. He takes it, and Dergy with a one. Clan Zoo cleaning the round out. You can see it happening from a mile and a half away. TPM thinking twice about their timeout and going, oh, maybe we should just go on a fast strat with the pistols and brought up for this one. Right now, their eco. This is going to be tough. Going for the draw. It's not what you want in the first game. First game, first series of the week one of League.
Definitely not, but I don't know, I suppose it's just that current play style. Like, they are a very team... Sorry. They're playing a very trade-oriented game, which is how it should be, but they just need to, you know, pump the pace up a bit, push stuff together, instead of waiting till 30 seconds is left on the clock and then doing something. I mean, both ways pay off, but... Just need a bit more variation, because as it stands, they're just running down the clock.
They're so hesitant right now, they're not sure what they want to do.
Yeah, exactly.
Still time to go.
Oh, Ruthless.
Fans who are moving. Oh. Ruthless up aggressive.
Gets punished for the smoke push.
He does indeed. M4 now in the hand of Rideup. They have worked around to the B bomb site. But not really setting up for the attack as of yet, and I do believe Nature... They've done this academy quite well. Same Clan Zoo, just making a bit of noise at the other bomb site to hold that rotation. Going to give the guys opportunities to go. The counter's coming out from the CT. So Peak and Troy will notice Nature goes down. Now, two on the bomb site of B. They're going to push in. There's a monster.
And the last one.
That will be done.
15-11.
Academy Oof. Eco round completely caught out. Jared.
So Skinny's got a drop. That means I'm seeing no more than $1,000 worth of nades coming out from the T's at this point, because everybody's got to drop guns to get armor. Oh, actually, no, they got a lot of them. What the hell?
No.
Oh, right.
Twisted doesn't have much. Twisted dropped. They're able to get a lot out of this round, but they're playing for the Tide right now.
Nature's got a good little as well.
And we have a second map to go to as well, which is Mirage. Which is
that is true.
Next. I don't know right now. It's sort of Fort Clanzoo. This is their map to work with. Academy, they had opportunities, and funny enough, yes, they were around behind at half, but they had four ecos in those rounds as well, buying quite heavily, investing a lot on the CT side. But where it really worked for them gaining the rounds was the ability to take the guns off Clanzoo when they were on their eco. But Clanzoo have really done well on the CT side at the moment, being traded out. Maybe a holdout round, and Clanzoo got to think twice again.
3v4 here, going to A. All default has to do is just chill, legit. Just made no noise, but he's already scoped in, and they still haven't realized. Nature's about to drop. Bang.
He shouldn't be peeking the same line. That's the scary part about this.
He's got the crossfire, and that's it.
The crossfire was good, and that will be the first game done here, ladies and gentlemen. Going 16-11 to Clanzoo. I'm going to head into the second map of Mirage. Interesting.
I think we should take about a minute break before we kick into this.
Yeah, oh, they won't be going too early. They'll have a little bit of a break. So we'll just get rid of the sound there as they start to load and sort out their guns. But let's just break that map down, Jared. Being sort of, we thought it could have gone either way. And I was just speaking before about TPM's ability on the CT side of Ecos to actually take guns off Clanzoo. But Clanzoo going on the CT side, you could see TPM a little bit wayward with rushing. And I think not getting the control of having an advantage at the halftime sort of put themselves in that motion. There's sort of so many points we can talk about where TPM could have actually gained control, actually have the rounds in their favour, and then they could have worked a lot better as a T-side, but Clanzoo just sort of holding on to that, and they worked a lot better as a T-side unit.
Yeah, definitely. And as I was saying, not the main issue, but one of the things that's very apparent with both teams is they're very reluctant to get a little aggressive or get a little bit more information. So I think that's why you could see from Clanzoo there, Force by rounds or the eco rounds, they were very, very slow and methodical, whereas TPM were just all up in their face. And it's quite surprising because in both halves, both strategies paid off. So I think it may just have come down to the map, you know? Like, Mirage is one of those maps that everybody knows every smoke, every Molotov, every flash, every hiding place. So yep. It's going to be a completely different game. I'm not saying it's going to be... Actually, I kind of feel like this one's going to go heavily in one team's favor. I'm talking like a 16-5. Towards who? I don't know yet, but it's one of those maps where everything just feels autonomous, you know? Like, you know what you need to do before you do it, so it just gets done.
Let's talk AWPs. I think it was Slick Rick that was running the AWP for TPM and Default running it for Clanzoo. Both of them not really hitting their shots. Opportunity's gone begging to really get advantages. Being Mirage, the next map coming up, this is going to be a map that's going to... The AWP picks is going to be important in their midsection.
Yeah, very, very important in the middle. And also, it's... The map itself has a lot more opportunities for you to be very aggressive with the AWP on Mirage, I feel, compared to Cache. There's a lot of different peaks you can do. I mean... In middle alone, you can peek from short, window, connector, the staircase on connector for a cheeky headshot as well. So there's four odd angles.
And it all depends how the play be short as well. I'm expecting that to be sort of a real aggressive position for both teams, and sort of probably a lot of battle fronts is going to happen in that motion, as well as a T connector into the A bomb site. That's going to be interesting placement. and how both teams hold. Going with what we think would be a knife round coming out, TPM obviously had the two players alive in the last one against Clanzu. Maybe probably fancied themselves chances on knife, maybe to repeat it again. Do they start on T and sort of go, right, we're going to use our strats and see if they can get themselves a good handy lead, or just go be safe and stay on a CT side? But in saying that, this map, it can go either or on both sides. So does TPM have the ability to hold well on the CT side? That's the question.
Yeah, it's very hard to say, because on a map like this, you can have so much success with just doing the simplest things, you know? So it doesn't matter whether you start T or CT. So many times I've just seen just like a straight up run B pay off. So if anything that they, if any of their strats or whatever or their peaks just aren't working out, they can just go, you know, screw it, rush B, and it works. Works very well.
Okay, all right. So we are waiting for the players to all get sorted. So what we're going to quickly do, guys, is take a break here. Just a quick 2-minute break, and we'll be jumping right back into it. So don't go anywhere. Stick around. We'll be back with more CSGO action here at the WA Gamers League Season 1. We'll be back for Map 2 Mirage.
Yep. Stay tuned.